Hello there everyone, this is Iron Mark 3 and welcome back to Survival with me, Iron Mark 3, in the Vehicle Designer, so there's no actual survival going on. Yep, I'm continuing to build here, and as you can see, this thing works. Yeah, I was trying to do a bit of timing to have that thing appear when I wanted it to, but I'm having a hard time judging distance, so yeah, this thing... I also find that it's easier for me to focus on this and do it with the breaking up into hours things that I did last video, so I'm going to do that again this time. But between videos I did, as I said I would, I installed the hydrofoil pods. I've actually repositioned them a bit more so they're spread out around the corners of the vehicle. And then I decided a performance test was in order to make sure that the thing actually works, because, let's be fair, I was confusing a lot of people with the first video building this with the odd shape of it, I think. Like, it was a weight that's supposed to be a boat kind of deal, I think, more or less. So, I figured a performance test to make sure that it was all working okay and it would actually stay up was in order. And as you can see, it's doing okay. It's staying up. It's slow as hell, but that's because it's barely operating. I was actually messing around with the throttle settings on the engines I've got. And it turns out that this thing can actually stay up like this at about 7 meters per second speed. So that's all it needs to stay up and have its weapons bays and things out of the water. So yeah. Of course, it's a temporary power plant. I've just whacked a couple of 5K engines and some fuel onto the back of it. And that's all it's got so far. It's actually moving at 8, so yeah. About 7 to 8 meters a second is all it requires. Less than that, the front dips down because the front is heavy right now. And then eventually it just settles into the water. But right now it's actually got a reasonable speed for such a big craft. Well, for such a big craft, it's actually got a really good speed. But here, let me open the taps and let me show you. Full throttle. And as you can see, the hydrofoils are now overcompensating because they react, as you know, to the depth settings. It's like immediately switch it to full up or down, and as a result it just bounces in and out of the water like a crazy thing. Well, honestly that's pretty tame. It's also completely flat as well, which helps, but you know, it's doing 30, well hang on, speed vertically is fluctuating, but in terms of lateral speed it's doing about 30 odd meters a second and being extremely loud with the number of jets. But yeah, it can move. I can get a smoother ride later on when I actually have the bulk of the craft sorted out, and then I can fiddle with the hydrofoils more. So for now I'm going to have to put up with the bouncing really, but it proves it works, so that's what I was aiming to do with this little exercise. It also shows that the craft needs a lot more power too. That is also a thing, because I wanted to actually go at the speed limit for jets, so about 90. That'd be great for this craft, but it's only managing 30 right now, so it needs a lot more power. Especially since it's going to get heavier from here on out. Though, the hydrofoil pods are as big as they need to be, probably too big to be honest. So I don't need to do that anymore. All stop, let it sink. But yeah, Discovery, as it's called now, you guys get to pick the name when it's actually launches into the campaign, is very much a viable craft at this point, and it can move around, with the sole exception of not being able to turn because I haven't installed any turning systems. That is a slight flaw, that I might want to do something about that. But yeah, as you can see, the nose is starting to dip down. Also, the hydrofoils are sitting a little bit higher in the water than I want. I want them to be slightly lower than that, so another setting to be fixed there. But yep, down it goes. Let's get started. Now, I must admit, there is a slight concern with this craft, actually. Let's set that to 4. So, keep the hydrofoils a little bit deeper. And the concern is not actually to do with the craft itself. Now, the concern is actually to do with my computer. And I am somewhat worried, because my computer struggles with high block counts. It's by no means a powerful computer by any stretch of the imagination. And that has ended series in From the Depths from my channel before. But I must also point out that there has been some serious optimizations in the game since then as well, so I'm also kind of exploring the current limits of what my computer and the game can do. This craft right now is 16,000 block limits. I think I pushed as high as maybe 18 to 20 on some of my previous series, but yeah, as you can see, now it's dropping past 6, it's starting to dip quite badly. And it'll just keep getting worse. But yeah, I pushed as high as about 18 to 20, I think, in previous series. And then the computer was really struggling. But that was also with lots of cannon shells and missiles and things going around as well, so maybe I'm being pessimistic, as I tend to be. I don't know. Don't worry, this isn't going to be another video of me bashing myself again. Because a few people commented on that last time, actually. That I was bashing myself a bit unfairly and being a bit harsh myself. And sadly, that's how I am, I'm afraid. So, yeah. Anyway. I don't have much experience with these things. I want to check the controller, I think. Yeah. For my power situation, I think I'm going to take a custom jet. Let's mount that there. Then I want a... No, wait. Actually, I want this further back now. Let's do it. Hang on. I want a combustor and a fuel injector. So let's do it like this. I'm sorry. This is another case of me not really knowing what I'm doing. Because A, that's funnier for everyone involved. B, that's highly confusing, which leads to more fun. And C, I... Reasons. Yes, reasons. Anyway, let's get this thing sorted. I need an exhaust, of course. Source that. And you know what help? Mirror mode would really, really help. So let's grab that. Okay. I was always thinking that I might have to use custom jets for this thing. And that's looks to be pretty accurate. Because I need the power and I need the density, so a custom jet for sheer throttle is going to be required to boost the power and get the speed up. And that means I've got to work this out, and that's going to be my focus for today. Getting more power sorted out. Let's see, compressors, intakes on the front, right, compressors. That's fine. I don't want to have the fuel running too high. So how much fuel is this using? Fuel use per minute, maximum. Yeah, but that increases as I expand the thing, I think. So let's actually whack on a compressor. It sucks that I have to go back to the jet controller to check this. Let's see. Yeah. Yeah, that increases it. So, as one in... I'll just try building with one injector for now. Anyway, let's get a single compressor, single intake. I shouldn't have deleted those, but you know, I do things, maybe they even work sometimes. Oh, who knows? I'm just going to get this set up right now, like that. Then I'm going to put on the compressors. Anyway, I've got comments and things to talk about, so let us begin with that. I've already mentioned people saying the whole thing about me hitting myself a bit too much. I agree, and I apologise, but sometimes I get like that, so I don't really make any excuses. I want a 3... No, a 5x5. And length 1. Yep, and then I'm just going to grab this one because it's a set of compressors. Then I'm going to take another one. 5, 5, 1, and I'm going to grab the intakes. So there we go. I can now place these down as prefabs, and I won't have to mess around as much. So I can take the intakes off it now. But I mentioned this in the comments, so I might as well mention it now, make this properly official, like, hey, you know this little thing about me. I have seriously bad self-confidence. As in massively bad self-confidence. Being able to talk to you guys on YouTube like this is actually a massive improvement. Seriously, I don't even recognize myself in this regards from like even last year, and I've been improving at a gigantic rate since I got my job as a sales assistant, which absolutely scared me silly. So yeah, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Let's make this a 20. So let's get that 20. There we go. Whole load of compressors. So that's looking big and complex. Power output 20. Yeah. All right. This might be bad. Okay. Now I know that there's a boost if you put on an extra intake, because I've experimented a little bit with these engines, but that was ages back. So if I put those two on and have to go all the way back. Yep, max output is now 11,000. I put the intakes on 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Anyway, yeah, my social skills suck. I am actually terrified of people in general and crowds and things. I get very nervous. Max power is 83. Okay, that's looking pretty nice. And oh yeah, prefabs. Prefabs no worky on that. There we go. I'm going to have to do the same on this side, so hooray. Where does this go to? Actually, let's just measure that so I don't have to count. I can keep talking. So yeah, me no social skills. Me speak good. Me person, I guess. I was always the kid that didn't talk to people. I was... On my report cards at school, it was always a case of, his punctuality is legendary. He's always waiting. He's the first in line for the class. That's because I don't have anything else to do, so I'm just standing outside the door reading a book. So there you go. That's me at school. I was the one that didn't have any friends and was just sitting around reading a book all the time because reasons. Hell, when I went to university for an introductory course, it... Yeah, they mentioned that because at the end of this introduction course, they did little awards scheme saying, you're the best at this kind of thing. And I was the one noted for always having a book in his hand. So they gave me some really old paperbacks from the Star Wars series, which I'd never actually read. So I actually owe them for that. They were my first Star Wars books. And it was like, these are actually pretty good. So, yeah. They introduced me to a whole thing, and it's like, yep, that was pretty interesting. Also, as a note of interest on that, they did a test, because this was a whole mechanical engineering thing. It was like, what role would you fill in a engineering team? I was the only one in the entire group rated as a plant. Yes, you heard me right, a plant. And by that, I mean... the guy who provides that 1% of genius, who comes up with a random idea, who solves a thing and takes it to sometimes allows it to go to another level kind of thing. So you'd think that's pretty good, right? Sort of. Anyway, 83,000, that's looking pretty nice. Let's actually open the taps again and see how this does. I want to make sure that I've got this thing working right, so... Power! Oopsie-daisy! Up comes the back, up comes the front, stabilizing. That's added 10 meters a second to it. Then again, I also know that proportionally you have to add a lot more power as you add more stuff, so... Hey, that's definitely an improvement. Pause it there. Also, custom jets look pretty nice. It's like they're flipping rockets or something. I'll have to use those more often, I think. Oh, sadly, there is the fuel use issue, but then again, I'm planning to put refiners into this thing anyway, so, you know, that's not such a bad thing. But yeah, speed of 40 now. Okay, let's see if I can improve the power ratio a bit. There we go. So yeah, the guy who comes in and supplies the genius and is like, yay, you're the smart one. Not really. That's not what it means. What it means is I'm the one that's going to come up with an odd idea or something that might be a bit outside the box. So in some ways it means I'm a crazy or unconventional one, which, you know, it's not a reflection of how smart I may or may not be. 83,000, okay. What happens if I pull out... I know there's a ratio thing involved. So I'm going to pull out this rack of compressors. Help if I can actually tell what I was doing. Right. And then I'm going to mount a intake instead. I remember reading about this in the wiki. It's like, intakes can make more efficient. Sorry, one of these things can make more efficient, but less powerful for the length. So you choose, like, do you want power or do you want efficiency kind of thing. I should probably look this up so I actually have a vague idea what I'm doing. Might help, but yes. So yeah, a plant is the weird one, and that is reflected. Okay, that's dropped my power slightly. Let's extend the intakes to the front of the craft then, see what the maximum length will do. It's not far to go because I'm pretty near the front as it is, so let's go ahead. So yeah, the rest of what they said about the plant is they can do all the ideas and things, so they can shoot you to another level on your project, but they're also the one that's going to turn up to work in a dressing gown and fluffy rabbit slippers, which I thought was absolutely amusing as heck. And very tempting. But also, I don't actually own fluffy rabbit slippers, I must point that out, so it would be a bit tricky to pull off. I don't have any. Which, now that I think about it, is actually a major oversight on my part, because I suddenly want some. And what does that say about me? Okay, I better leave this front section around for armor, so yeah. Let's go ahead and install the other side and see how that goes. So yeah, that was a thing. Social skills, not my thing. Self-confidence, don't really have much. I may sound it, but that's really... I'm very good at putting on the acts. Sometimes I half believe it, often I don't. And partly it's me also turning my generally sarcastic sense of humour back on myself and, you know... So if I'm bashing myself, part of it's serious, part of it's not. And no one knows the difference, not even me. Ooh. 166. Okay, let's see what that does. I've doubled it. A massive bank of compressors is definitely helping. Throttle up. Full power. Oops. Bouncing around. Fine. The back is still extremely light. It's up to speed and it's now bopping at 50. Okay, that's another 10 meters a second. Right. I think I need more... Yeah, I think I need another set of those things. Okay. Throttle down again. They're using a fair bit, massive amount of fuel, so I'm going to have to do something about that. But the thing with fuel systems is, you know, the efficiency is in the refinery. So if you're gulping a lot of fuel, what you really need is a massive refinery setting. So get your refinery effective, and your fuel system will be a lot more useful in general. Oh, that's just clipping into the outer armor there, so that's actually a fine place for it. Increase my fuel consumption dramatically, but increase my thrust, which is what I'm after. This thing can go places, so, you know, it's definitely becoming mobile. Though the hull is still largely incomplete and all that too, so, you know. Yep, that's all in place. Okay. I could probably extend this side a little bit more, but I want to keep that front section available for mounting armor and shielding and things. So yeah, that's telling you a bit about myself and why I tend to hit on myself a lot more sometimes. One comment was that I'm in a depressive cycle, and yeah, that does happen still more often than not, I'd like. But then again, I was suffering from depression constantly for about 10 flipping years, so, you know, I don't want to go back for that. So, there we go. Anyway, that's enough about my personal problems in that regard. So, thank you for the concern. I do appreciate it. Next thing is... Actually, this one is from Svorti, which they said I got a lot done in an hour, even though I was unhappy with my overall level of progress. And they go slower because switching their mines a lot, changing their mines rapidly and all that kind of thing. Lathrix, I believe. Yeah, it was Lathrix. Lathrix mentions that he has this problem as well, which is why he skips out the building process on his videos a lot, because he changes his mind all the time. Well, my response was, I generally have an idea of what I want to do. In this case, as you can see, I'm playing around with the power systems and getting this thing more mobile. Ooh, it's 65 to roughly 70 right now, so that's, again, good. But again, not quite the level I want, so... Also, look at my fuel. It's going bye-bye very, very quickly. So I go in with a general idea of what I want to do, so that's why I'm focusing on what I'm doing. Last time around, I focused on getting initial engine set up and then getting hydrofoils to get this thing actually steady and up out of the water. So that my fuel tanks are about to go, so I might as well stop there. Still pretty... it's getting really fast, but it requires more power. I did actually anticipate this, so I'm going to have to add some more thrust in the form of some more jets. I was thinking I would have to. Yeah, this, the underside of this thing is turning into a massive jet engine, basically. Also, I better replace the fuel tanks just to make sure. These fuel tanks were only installed for initial jet testing, so, you know, like that. That's why the entire assembly is just tacked onto here, so I can just scrap it and the entire thing will just drop off flat, because that's not finished by any stretch of the imagination. Let's actually mount some... I want to get this thing starting to slope back, so... let's get the prefab again. Hope I was doing the right thing. Yes. Take the prefab. So yeah, there's nothing wrong with having lots of ideas. In fact, I kind of envy people who have lots and lots of ideas, because I'm not one of them. I have ideas, yes, but I don't have lots and lots of them. What I do is, as I said, let's... 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's really start sloping this thing back, because this craft needs more power towards the rear. Like that. How much space am I getting? Yeah, let's do it here. I'll slip it back. As I mentioned in the comment, I go in with the same thing I was doing, and then I evolve it as I go, so it's like, I knew the basic pattern I was trying to do with those side thrusters there, and then I put the cowlings on, stuff like that. I wasn't sure if I'd go for all the small thrusters, but then I did anyway, because, you know, increasing the overall volume of thrusts, so that kind of thing. I'm not going to take those off, even if they are only contributing a small amount of my craft's current thrust, because they just look nice and they can still provide some, so, you know. Plus they will act as massive heat decoys for any heat-seeking missiles that come my way, so that's an improvement. I'd rather a heat-seeker hits those engine mounts there rather than hits one of these big jet engines in the middle, so, yeah. I think with this one, actually, once I get the front of it to the front of the craft, and check the speed again. I'll actually stop doing this on the jets, so I'll move on to my next thingy, my next fiendish plan, which I think will be actually getting a refinery set up and storage set up so that I can actually supply this thing and also turning thrusters. So yeah, as you can see, it's like snap out a couple of vague plans, like this is what I want to do. This is what I'm going to try to do. What's the angle on that? 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. I can always steepen the angle on there, I suppose, but I think that might be about as far as I want to take it. 1, 2. Yeah, let's put that there. That's as far as I want it to go. Okay. So these things will be a little bit more powerful. Put that there, put that there, and put that there. Okay. Yeah. That's going to be the limit of my engines. for the time being, as far as forward propulsion is concerned. But it's definitely getting there. It's going places. And what I was doing there was I was adapting a little bit on the fly. So, you know, I was thinking about where I want the hull at the front to go. And I know I'm probably telling... someone how to use a fork or what a knife is or something like that. I know this is all really, really basic stuff, but sadly, this is how I tend to do things a bit. Ooh, I'm actually hitting... Yeah, 75 forward thrust, roughly, I think. Yep, and then the up and down is accounting for the extra 5, that's why I'm knocking 5 off, but that's still... For a graph this big, that is really tearing along now. I'm as fast as most flyers go that are using just standard jets and things, so... Well, actually, I'm faster than a bunch of them, so... Yep, that's definitely good. Right, you can stop now, and let's hit caps lock to get you out of the water as soon as I go into build mode, because I didn't do that. There we go. Up you go. Excellent. Now, this fuel engine set has served its purpose, so I'm just going to scrap it off it. Bye-bye. And, of course, I've dropped into the water, so I need to teleport back to my... Whoa! I didn't know I was... Oh, wow. I'm off the grid, apparently. Wow. A long way off the grid. Okay, let's pull that craft out. Teleport to it. Point. Moving out. Yep, and since I just wiped something, it doesn't know it's top speed, so I'm going to have to put it back in. Da-da-da, bit of lag, da-da-da. So yeah, basically I think it's just general approach, and as I said, I envy having lots of ideas. I generally have a couple of ideas then act on them without really thinking about what's going on. Also, that's right, this thing can't move anymore because I just took out the... Oh well, I'll just sit out here then and work on it, but I'll quickly save in case something happens from me being outside them, being so far out of bounds. So yep, there we go. Get back up in the air, please. Yeah, you saw the front just doing a nosedive straight into the depths of the water, so that's because of how front heavy it is right now. Anyway, next step. I backed up these engines. I wish I had more ideas and things, but I'm frankly much better and more comfortable just doing what I have a vague idea what I'm doing, so that's why I do things this way. It's my whole... style thing. Right. I'm going to put that there. Since I don't think that'll affect us at all. Actually, it might, so that's a concern. Okay. But yeah, I'm going to start sloping this thing back. If I need more of these big jets, I can mount them higher. And that'll do for that. But right now I want a refinery section to be installed. So let's find out where my 4 grids are, which is here. Okay, so that's 4 grids. So that's going to be like that. Okay. Again, that's just temporary. That's just me marking the place. So I know where my 4... If I was building 4 lengths, that's where they will end up. Now, refineries. Let's add some fuel systems to this thing to actually, you know, produce fuel, since I need fuel. Fuel is good. Fuel will let me run these massive thirsty engines, which, let's bring each other's. 4.5. Okay, that's 27,000 fuel per minute. Pretty nasty. Pretty nasty for full throttle. 27,000 fuel a minute. Okay, yeah. I'm going to have to do what I thought. Which is means I'm going to take that, and I'm going to extend the back out. It's okay, I need more back weight anyway, so do it like that. I've got a whole bunch of space underneath, so that's going to help. But right now, refineries are what I want, so... This is just temporary platforms. I'm going to tear these out later. That's the central line, so I want that one. Okay, right. Resources. Fuel refinery. Let's Actually, let's work this out first. Right. Get rid of that. Since I want this thing to be pretty efficient, because, you know, survival mode, don't want to waste resources. But I want to also be able to produce enough that I'm going to be able to, you know, keep operating. So this requires a quick bit of testing. And let's put two refineries side by side. Now, to get that freaking 27,000 fuel, I'm going to need more than that because I'm going to need power for the rest of my systems too. I'm going to need a whole bunch of refineries actually to keep up with that. And I know that for a fact. So let's go ahead and add the stabilizer to these things. Higher efficiency. Okay, let's add some fuel stacks. Just to make sure that they don't go bang on me, because that might be a bad thing. Okay, now, I want to decide what I want to do with this, because I want to have a certain amount per refinery. That's what I want to do. And there was a stat which tells me, but I suspect because I don't have any storage, that's why it's not doing that right now. So I'm going to put in a storage tank. And I'm going to put in a resource. No, I don't need a resource storage. I've already got resource storage. What am I on about? It's strange. It should tell me how much it's doing. Converting that, right. If I just take 3 seconds, refinery efficiency. Am I just missing something here? For every unit of material, it creates fuel. Every batch, right. I know it told me how much it does per second. Oh, no. Doi. Okay, right. I was looking in the wrong place. It's actually per minute. That's what it tells me. So, 981 per minute, 666 fuel per minute. So, adding in these has actually dropped it down quite a bit. 635, 613. So, yeah. What are these? The refinery cokers, which are 30% more efficiency. Right. Okay, let's add in this one on this side, see what this one does. Let's, yeah. All right, 200 minerals. I should take 3 seconds. 491. Hang on. This is dropping. This doesn't seem right. I need more experience with these things, clearly. But yeah, that. Okay, that's not what I want. I want these things to be pretty high in terms of their output. Otherwise, I'm going to have a massive amount of them, which is not going to be the best. Let's see. But even this is just doing 981. I don't. This. Me brainy no worky. Basically. I was getting better than this testing, so has something changed? I don't know. Efficiency factor increase, process time increase, let's take that out. Ah, okay, let's flicking check it. Right. Basic. 1070. This way I'm going to have to make some pretty long things. So let's go ahead and add in those. Since I want the stacks to be better, I want less stacks. Let's set my number lower. I was aiming for 1,000 per refinery, but that doesn't seem to be pretty realistic. Instead, I'll aim for like 500. I'm kind of wondering what happened to my testing, though. Because I tested at something and I was getting 1,000, so I don't know what's going on. I'm guessing things were merging together, like, if I add this another refinery, does that stack it? No. Okay. Oh well, good thought, but no. 428, 478, 589. For 200 material, though. That's still not very good. Fine, let's do this more cheaper. 446, 421, for 71, 404, okay, let's go for freaking 400, fine. Now, for 400, this will be like that, I think. Actually, can this reach 400? No, it can't. It's not getting any better. Fine. Right. Sorry, I'm just like, what am I doing? Testing. But yeah. 109 for 500. 59 for 400. Which one's more efficient? That's taking 60 for 400. That's 120 for 800. Yeah, that one is more efficient. That one is more efficient. Well, I don't want it to be massive. I don't want a massive refinery complex on my craft. Then again, what am I talking about? Of course I'm going to want a massive refinery complex on my craft. I'm going to tear these out. Anyway. This is, again, still a survival craft at heart, so I need to be aware of that. So, yep. That looks like this is the way to go. I'm going to be running it this way. Also, let's add the fuel stacks to the other side. So there we go. You're working. I want to make sure you're not getting any gas. 384 for 43. Yeah, that's still a big improvement. Plus it helps if I have the high explosive parts actually, you know, deeper. But 38. This is the gains are getting too small now, so I think I'll leave that at that. So okay, that's going to be my fuel refining line like that. So actually move that fuel storage. Yes. Capture prefabs. Let's see. Wipe that. Capture. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 27, 28. Go spot on, and there we go, got it right. So that's going to be my refining level and efficiency, really pretty effective for the amount of materials. So that's that. I'm going to, of course, have RTGs and systems as well, so doing that. But the thing is, I need the fuel for these big jets now, so I have to be able to supply these with my refineries and fuel storage, and that means I need to be doing this, spin it around. The thing is, though, I don't want this thing to take up massive tracts of space in my vehicle, so that's one thing I need to consider. Also, I suspect I'm not getting the full picture on dangerous gas emissions because, you know, the refineries weren't really working, so that's the thing. I should probably check that, but for now, I'm going to start placing these things down to actually get fuel production going. So, like that, check. And then that'll stop them overlapping. As you can see, I've got the explodey bit a bit further back. So let's do this. Then place another prefab. So that. And I'm doing it like this because I want them to be separated at least a little bit. Better endurance that way. Explodey bits are deeper in the craft, so less vulnerable. And do it like that. So, there we go. Hang on, that one. 384, 330. Oh, yeah, altitude. Right. The altitude. I forgot altitude is a thing. Okay. Let's actually scrap those two refineries really quick. And actually, let's scrap out these ones too. Bye-bye. The altitude is actually having a really major... That's why. Of course. Altitude. If I put in... Where's the middle? Oh, that's the middle. Spot on. Right, okay. Place in a refinery. Get this thing. Anyway, sorry. I got caught up in just doing like... and then I stopped talking about stuff, so... Let's do this like that. Then if I drop it, oh look, suddenly it's producing massive amounts. Oh boy. Okay. Stupid. Right. This means I've got to remount it somewhere else. Okay, let's put to use this lowered hull section back here. I'm sorry. Look at me, this is me changing my mind. It's like I discovered something that's like, oh, okay, let's change this bit here and this bot there and blah, 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 blah. Let's see, I need to mount this a bit lower. So, do this. Oh, that reminds me. There is actually another comment I need to respond to. And apparently, one of the great gods of FTD, according to what Swarty said again. I mentioned Swarty so much, but they do help me a huge amount. One of the great gods of FTD watches my videos, and it's like, really? Wow, thank you. I'm honoured, actually. So, yeah, thank you. But anyway, they pointed out something, and I think I should respond to it, so go me. Yep, this still offers some good clearance, so that's fine. I'm going to put my farmers at this level here. So yeah, get them lower to the surface so they work better. And I'm going to pack it from the middle, so yep, let's put this. How far back is that going to be? I actually want it to slope, so I want this to be further forwards, like so. Yep, and then I'll put some in here. I've got some place for one more. Yep, there we go. So there we go, I'm getting some fuel refining going on. Like that. Okay. And as you can see, I've just sloped the armor down a bit. But yeah, they pointed out that it was aimed at the using sloped armor as backup behind main armor to get the armor value. It is technically an exploit kind of thing. And get out of the water. 2,000 a minute. I knew I was getting better value out of the things I was testing, but yeah, 2,000 a minute. Wow. So at operating level where this vehicle's going to sit, they are producing 2,000 fuel a minute. Wow. Okay, yeah, that is roughly where the things are going to sit while this craft is actually working. So yeah, 2,000 a minute. That batch alone there is making 10,000. That is pretty good. They're also overloading like crazy from the heat, I think. Yes, yes, they are. Right. I knew that was going to be a problem. Okay, let's get this sorted out before they go bang on me, because, you know, that's going to happen. But yeah, using the sloped armor to reinforce my armor is considered an exploit. Yep, this is looking pretty close to my test setup now, so let's just increase it to 6. Like that to ensure that they don't explode on me. So yeah, this thing is going to have a behind that's on fire. And 6 will keep everything sorted out. But basically, this craft is very, very vulnerable, very hot at the back as it's going. So, yeah, anyway. Sorry, I'm going back and forth because I'm... Yep, 2,000 per, that's fine. 19.7. That means that to run my jets, I require 3 rows of these. So, yeah, let's go ahead. Wipe and recapture that, so I've got the correct stuff. Increase its length like that. But yeah, would have had to put it in the right place, wouldn't it? Begin capture. Up one. There we go. Right, got the refineries. Perfect. And that was seriously. I will complete this train of thought. Don't worry, I will. That sloped armor is considered an exploit because the armor mechanics don't yet take into account how that works and how it can benefit a craft, making it lighter, stronger, so and so and so forth. So that is entirely accurate and I agree 100%. That's why I don't typically use it. I must point that out. I don't typically use it. Most of my vehicles don't actually exploit this mechanic at all. I tend to just put in heavy armor, that's it. There have been a couple of vehicles in the main series, like the Mantis tank and its variants actually use this. They use sloped armor for behind their regular armor layers for reinforcements. But the thing is that they actually use sloped armor, well, flat out in many places as a replacement for their regular armor. And that's entirely because of the fact that, well, it's entirely down to the volume restrictions in the campaign itself and the block limits. So just trying to fit them in. This case I have deliberately refitted, as I mentioned in the last video, I deliberately refitted to use sloped armor. And yes, I admit I did that based on comments. Ooh, I'm not going to be able to fit that in that row, am I? No, I'm not, actually, so... That's okay, I'll narrow it to four and put in another two rows there, so that's fine. Yeah. So I installed it in response to your comments, and I'm not blaming you guys or anything for that. I want to point that out. So yeah, you guys mentioned it, that was a thing, pointed out how good it would be, and I used it willingly of my own free will. But it is not typically a technique I make use of. And the reason for that is, if you've been with my channel a while, then you probably know this. I don't like using exploits much at all. As in, I avoid active cheats and big glitches and things like that. I tend to avoid them and not make use of them. Because, you know, I prefer to play games as they... within the rules that they set. Let's put it that way. And let's add another bank of four refineries on top of this. So this thing is going to chew through materials like an absolute bugger, but it's going to be producing fuel, and when the fuel is full, it won't be chewing the materials, so... Yeah. And it's going to be doing it at a pretty high efficiency rate, for the most part. Actually, how will these ones operate? These will... Actually... $600 per, so that's not... I'm going to have to turn my bottom row into refineries, aren't I? I think I am. Since I want this thing to be fuel efficient. I mean, that looks great at all, that stack, but... Yeah, look at me, I'm changing my mind again. Anyway, this craft is using armor slopes where... for how they're not meant to be used, basically. But on the other hand, that's entirely necessary for how this craft functions, so... Yeah. And the reason... It's entirely for one reason, really. Bye-bye those. Yep, the reason is entirely because I can't format my words properly and stuff like that. No, that's not really the reason. It's just the cost. As you've seen from this thing moving, and as I've been saying from the start, weight is not an issue, so I don't need to do that for the weight saving. This craft, though... It's just the sheer cost of it compared to the resources I have available, so that's basically why it's here. That's why it's been done. And it looks like I'm going to be blowing lots and lots of hot exhaust into my own craft interior, so not ideal at all, but I need the refinery efficiency, so that's how it's going to have to be. That's 20,000 fuel refining, and then I'll need another bank. Oh geez, that's going to be too big. Alright, okay. I'm going to have to modify my refinery setup. And this is why I lament my progress sometimes. Because I don't get as much done as I want to get done. And so it's like, I wanted to do this, and this, and this. And then it's like, nope, didn't have time, or I got hung up on something else. And it's like, that's where my opinion of my own speed tends to come from. It's like, I know you can do more, but you're not, so you're a moron. But yeah. And again, that's just me in a nutshell. I am a moron, and I'm going to keep calling myself a moron, so yeah. That's part of my charm. Yes. That's my excuse, I'm sticking to it. Anyway, how many have we got on here? One, two, three, seven. Okay, just grab that. That's that, and then I need the stacks. So, six stacks. That's seven stacks. Actually, five stacks should be fine, so there we go. Those stacks at the back, they're probably going to get damaged at some point, so more stacks is better, as far as those are concerned. Actually, I should probably reshape the sacks to better suit how I'm going to angle the back of the craft, but yeah. I'm focusing so much on the fuel system that I'm not actually doing anything regarding the... let's extend this bit part out here, actually, so... These are narrower... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... Okay, that's the refinery sets. Then I'm going to add the stacks into this knot here. Like that. So there we go, that's that refinery set it. Sorted. That's three more refineries packed in. Then I'm going to keep on doing that. I'm not going to widen it any further, so yeah, that's safe. This means that my ventral armor is actually going to be kind of weakish. But yeah, back to what I was saying. Me and my wandering around on topics, sheesh. Weight was never an issue for this craft because of, you know, that whole hydrofoil suspension bit. So, as you've seen, that's pretty darn effective. And this craft can stay out of the water very, very easily at a fraction of its full power. So that's fine. No problems there. Though it's not as fast as I want it to be, it's pretty good overall. It's entirely been a cost issue. That's entirely why I've swapped out all of the solid blocks for sloped blocks. Just so I could actually afford to get this craft more or less built at the size it is. I mean, if I hadn't done that, this would be costing around 900,000 resources right now. My campaign would be bankrupt, and it would be a case of... I can't spend any more on this, so I'd have to take this thing back into adventure mode more or less as it is now, actually. And then try to escape to a low zone and start trying to kill things to get more resources. Or, yeah, just flat out trying to kill things and survive, basically. Though odds are I'd get a lot of damage on the way out. So that's entirely why. Though this, I also mentioned this in the comment as well, so might as well do it here. I am going to, as resources become available, and the need for being so cheap disappears. And I'm going to have to move that forward, sadly, to fit a bit better. That's fine, I don't mind adjusting plans. Like that. As more resources become available, I'm going to refit and get more... I'm going to swap out some of those blocks, basically. I'm going to swap them out. I'm going to replace them with the solid stuff because having good armor value is great and all, but I know this thing is going to take an absolute hammering. It's a really big quacker of a target, even with how fast it's going to be able to move. And so, quite frankly, I prefer having solid blocks like I've kept on those forward sponsons. I specifically mentioned that last episode, actually. I kept solid blocks in the forward sponsons. Exactly because they would have more hit points, and so they would be able to take more damage before failing. So yes, that is my primary thinking with my armor as it is. I want the hit points, so as I get resources, I am going to be fitting out the sloped blocks for solid blocks again. And it's entirely a cost issue. So yeah, okay. I'm cheating because I require to at this point. Actually, no, it's not cheating, it's an exploit. It's not officially noted as a bug, but you know... I'm sorry, I'm wandering off track here, aren't I? I'm afraid this is one of my flaws as well. I get hung up on things so much sometimes. It's like, how long have I been waffling on about this? Like, looking at my timer, I think I've been talking about this for 20 minutes. Yeah. I've been talking about this for the last 20 minutes. It's like, sorry. Really sorry. I know I've probably offended a bunch of people just doing like this, but it's like, blah, 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 and things like that. But as I also said, I've made no bones about the fact that I don't tend to use exploits and things very much, so yeah. Sorry. That's just been my rant and alienating people who might watch this video for the day. I should point out at this point there is a dislike button below, so feel free to vent and hit that if you want to. I actually kind of make this a point. I don't mention like, comment, subscribe, stuff like that very much, though. Actually, I do. No, that's not right. I do mention comments sometimes. especially if I'm trying to talk and get a discussion or help about something or other. It's probably one of my pet peeves, actually, now that I think about it. Regarding like, comment, subscribe, things like that, it's actually the thing I mention most, I think. Comment. Talk to me. Yell at me. Tell me something. Yes. And I think that's going to be as far forward as my findings go, because that's getting close to the sloping. Yeah, I might actually pull out that refinery as I work on the forward hull. Next video, probably. But yes. How many refineries have I actually got packed into here now? Let's check. 5, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 refineries right now. That's actually practically where I wanted to be, so I could pack in another refinery, some more refineries on top here, and they will take care of producing extra fuel for my other power sources, so that's fine. So yeah, I've actually got my fuel conversion situation pretty much cracked, so yeah, that's good. Sadly, I was never going to get my turning issues cracked this particular video. I knew that because no matter how much I did, it was going to be like this graphic barely turned, but... Oh yeah, I have to move that forward, of course. Because basically this is a big heavy craft, so it's going to need a lot of turning power. So that means a lot of thrust at the back. And so that's going to need quite a lot of work on the thruster assemblies to go back there. How far close is that to the sloping? Again, pretty close. Yeah, that's... But anyway, that is actually enough fuel refining things in place. I'm going to move the stacks back here, so yeah. Another batch of stacks. There we go. Okay. Refinery sorted. Excellent. I don't have any fuel storage though, so they're not working. I've got plenty of material storage though, so there's that. But that's running at a high efficiency, like 2,000 fuel for 40 materials. So that's pretty good. Though my material drain rate is still going to be pretty high. Maybe I should add an ACB toggle to my control center just to turn the refineries off, so I can keep functioning on my regular jets without using the big boosters. Actually, that sounds like a good way to go. The ability to turn on and off the systems which supply these big boosters, that'll be a really good idea. Anyway, yeah, back to my rambling. Yay, random rambling. Yeah. Likes and dislikes, I'm fine either way. So if you feel like dropping a like, as you know, that does help the channel, as in gets more people to see the things, so that is all good. Actually, that's that. 1, 2, 3. Over there. Here. Yes, here. Again, this is all temporary. Don't mind this. But I'm gonna have my fuel storage safely nestled in the heart of the vehicle. This is actually going to be where my permanent fuel storage is. But I want to make it blast resistant, so that's 1, 2, 3. So that's the inner layer there of armor, like that. Yeah, like that. Okay. How much is that? 2, 3. Let's just level it out like that. So okay, this is where my fuel's going to be. Armor is going to be this thick around here. So if the fuel does detonate, it's not going to damage anything nearby. So that's going to be my armor layer, where that marked out right now by wooden blocks. I'll fix that soon. Excuse me. Yeah. Flipping. My throat's not all it can be, but it's okay right now. But yeah, back to what I was doing. Likes, comments, subscribe, watch my videos, praise me, adore me. I want your attention. I crave it. Yes. Well, I do like it, but if that becomes the focus of my channel, I might as well, in all honesty, pack it in and destroy the... And wait, was I using 3-block? I was. Oh. Whoops. Wait, why was I using 3 blocks? I'd have to double check all this. Anyway, if that ever becomes the focus of my channel, like I get onto the popularity contest train and stuff like that, it's like if I ever do that, then I might as well just stop, to be quite honest. Because if that ever becomes my focus, then basically I've failed my focus on the channel. Full stop. Okay, so it's like that. Right. This channel is entirely because I'm having fun doing it. That's my sole reason why it started. That's why it existed for 5 years with barely anyone watching. If you're still around after all that time, hey, thanks for sticking with me. But if I ever slip away from that, then this channel has basically failed. And I know for a fact that that has been... There have been a lot of YouTubers that have gone that way and just focused on the money and things like that, and it's led to some very questionable behaviour and things like that. And so if I don't want to go that way. Ever. Pretty much. Ever, 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 ever. I mean, I do some bad things. No doubt about it. Like, how much I've been struggling with the subscriber tournament is a really great example. Like, you guys have been wanting me to do it. I've been wanting to do it. I've just been able to do it. That's why it's not out, but it's still a thing. I must mention that, because someone asked that lately. Yes, it is still a thing. It is still very, very firmly on my my do list. Very firmly, like, a couple of people are not letting me forget, and I'm not letting myself forget at all. But I've just not been able to properly focus and get it done, which is aggravating me no end. How much fuel is that? 264,000. That's plenty of fuel. Actually, let's just tear that block back out. So yeah, the channel never about popularity. Though I still view the surge of people who came in to watch From the Depth stuff as a huge miracle in and of itself, so yay. Validate my existence kind of thing. But yes, seriously, thank you very much. But I'm not going to go like start yelling in a megaphone, watch me and adore me, because if I do, then I've lost, basically. And that'll do. I've not installed any turning thrust at all, so that one of my stated goals has not worked. But I've massively improved my power situation. I have. I don't have a main power plant, but my thrust capacity is very high now. I have the fuel refining ability to support it, and I have a fuel storage location. So this craft is getting better and better, and closer to being actually unleashed, which is the whole point. And I'm going to save it now. Save the vehicle. And yes, thank you very much for sticking with me. I guess I should point out right now, my current plan is to have 5 From the Depths videos per week. Not going to nail it down to a specific series, but 5 From the Depths videos per week. That's my current goal, and I think I can do that. So there'll be some series stuff, some building stuff, and some vehicle stuff to put up on the workshop. I'm actually working on a submarine to go up on the workshop right now. And that should be out later this week. But yeah. Stop babbling, call it there. You've been going for just over an hour. You've made progress, you've got some systems installed. So, you've done good. Come on, Iron Mark III, you've done good. Be satisfied. There was more I wanted to do though. But yeah, this has been Iron Mark III. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the show and I didn't bore you guys too much with all my random waffling. And as I said earlier, if I manage to offend anyone, then the dislike button is right below. Feel free to make use of it. Let me know. At least this time I'll actually have an idea of why I'll be getting dislikes. That's why I don't like the dislike button. Because I have no idea why I get them. And that is entirely why I dislike the button. Other than that, I think it's okay. So yeah. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you all some other time. I'll see you all later.